يحفظكم جميعا إن شاء الله. تفضلوا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا خاتم النبيين أبي القاسم محمد بن عبد الله، وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه الأخيار المنتجبين، وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين.
Although I can't hear anything.
جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه المجيد، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: إن تصبك حسنة تسؤهم. هلا بس نسمع هاي الآيات قبل 1400 سنة، هلا عينها تطبيقها بحياتنا، بلداننا، بشعوبنا، بمنطقتنا. إن تصبك حسنة تسؤهم، وإن تصبك مصيبة يقولوا قد أخذنا أمرنا من قبل، ويتولوا وهم فرحون. قل لن يصيبنا إلا ما كتب الله لنا هو مولانا، وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون.
Believers should be relying on Allah, God.
ونحن نتربص بكم أن يصيبكم الله بعذاب من عنده أو بأيدينا.
That you will get torture from God or from our hands. We are God said.
إن تكونوا تألمون
if you were,
فإنهم يألمون كما تألمون.
If you are feeling the pain, they are feeling the pain the same. If you want to get from the God whatever they don't get, God is the all wisdom.
في هذا اللقاء المبارك
in this blessed meeting, my
مقطع الأول
address has got two parts. The first one is the ethical one. This is condolences. The second part, it has got for the people who are responsible for this event. The third is about the battle in Gaza and Palestine and the area, the region. And the fourth one will be the Lebanon and the battle of Lebanon on Lebanon and the latest attack in the southern suburb. First, we have to renew our blessings and our condolences for the people of this event, the martyr, the big, the great leader Qasem Soleimani and his colleagues from the Iranians who have died martyred in Baghdad, and also Hajj Abu Mahdi Mohandas and his companions of the Iraqi people who were martyred on the way to the airport in Baghdad. To all their families, to their blessed families, we renew our condolences from Lebanon, condolences to losing our friends and dearest people, and for them to have reached or got this kind of badge from the Holy God. What's happened today close to the cemetery of Al-Hajj Qasem Soleimani's cemetery in Kerman, and targeting those who were visiting and renewing this kind of event, women, men and women and children, many of them have actually been martyred. I have noticed that it's more than 80 martyrs and 160 injured. And also we condole those their families. They are the same on the same path, the same battle which has been led by Suleiman. In our days, happiness and sadness are mixed.
نبارك
This is how we live.
المسيحيين والمسلمين جميعا
We congratulate
واللبنانيين خصوصا
Christians,
عيد
Muslims,
ميلاد
and
السيد
Lebanese,
المسيح عليه السلام
the
الذي
Christmas,
نرى
the birth of
إن شاء الله
Jesus.
في
We hope to
عودته
see
إلى هذه الدنيا
in his return to this
بشارة الخلاص
world
لكل المظلومين
the
والمستضعفين
salvation for
والمعذبين
all those
والمقهورين
vulnerable and
في هذا العام.
those who are tortured in this
أيضا
world.
نبارك
Also,
للجميع بداية
we will
العام
bless
الميلادي الجديد،
and
ونسأل
congratulate
الله
for the new
سبحانه وتعالى
New Year's Day,
أن
and
يعين
we hope that
الجميع
God will help
ليتغلبوا على
everybody
تحديات
to get rid of
الحياة المتنوعة
to the
العلمية
challenges of life,
السياسية
the
والاقتصادية
security, the
والمعيشية
political one,
والحياتية،
and
وأن
the living
يخلو
one,
هذا العام
and they
أفضل
will spend
مما
this
كانت
year
عليه
better
الأعوام
than
السابقة.
the
أيضا
previous years.
أبارك لكل
Also, I would like to
المسلمين
congratulate
والمسلمات
all
وخصوصا
Muslims,
لكل السيدات في أمتنا
in particular
مولد السيدة
women,
الزهراء عليه
for the
السلام، فاطمة
Zahra
بضعة
Fatima,
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، ابنة سيد الرسل، والتي
it's
كانت
the
ومن
daughter of
بقيت
the
وستبقى
Prophet,
سيدة
and
نساء
she will
العالمين وسيدة
be
نساء أهل الجنة.
one of the
نرجع
ladies
للتعازي.
of the
يجب أن
paradise.
أتوجه
We go back
بالتعزية
to the condolences.
بمناسبة
I would like to
فقداننا
condole for
لأخ
losing
حبيب وعزيز
a brother,
وقائد من
very
جيل
dearest
المؤسسين
and
في
leader,
مسيرتنا المباركة،
one of the founders in
خطيب
our
الجهاد
blessed path,
والمقاومة والمسيرة الإيمانية
the companion
الجهادية،
of jihad,
الحاج محمد ياغي، الحاج أبو سليم،
حاج محمد ياغي أبو
إلى
سليم,
عائلته الكريمة
to his
والشريفة فردا
family,
فردا، إلى كل إخواننا في السواحل،
each one by one,
وخصوصا إلى أهلنا في
condoling
البقاع.
them, and
الشيخ
in
وانبا
particular to those in
جل
البقاع,
عمره الشريف في خدمته.
because he spent most of his
يجب أن
time
ألفت
there
هنا أنه
in this
باعتبار
service.
نحن إن شاء الله سنقيم، حزب
We're
الله
gonna,
سيقيم حفلا يوم
Hezbollah will have
الجمعة
an
بعد
event
الظهر،
on Friday
وأنا
afternoon,
إن شاء الله سأكون
and
بإذن الله
hopefully
سبحانه
I will
وتعالى
be,
كان على قيد الحياة
if I've stayed
في خدمة
alive,
الإخوة
in the
والأخوات
service of
وسأتكلم،
the
وبالتالي
men and
هذا
women. I
سيساعدني
will
على
talk,
تقسيم
this will help me
الموضوعات التي كنت
to
أنا
divide
أود أن
the
أتحدث عنها
subjects
اليوم
that I've been
حتى لا أطيل عليكم
thinking, planning,
كثيرا،
talking
فبعض
about,
الموضوعات
so that I will not
سأؤجلها إلى
prolong my
خطاب الجمعة،
speech.
يعني
I
الكل
will
بتحكيهن أنت
leave
على
them
هذه الغيبة
on Friday.
التي تركنا
The things that I
لخدمتك
want
في
to
هذا
talk about,
الميدان هأرجع
we
أقسمهم
left it for
بين
the,
اليوم وبين
I'm gonna
بكرة إن شاء
divide them
الله.
between today and
يجب أيضا أن
Friday.
نوجه أن
I
نتوجه
would like to
للتبريك والتعزية
condole also
بشهادة الأخ
for
القائد
the
العميد
martyrdom
السيد رضي
of
الموسوي
the Colonel
الذي استشهد
Radi
قبل أيام
al-Mousawi,
في دمشق بغارة
who was killed
صهيونية.
by
هذا الشهيد
Zionist
العزيز القائد
raid in
المجاهد
Damascus. This
التقي
dearest
الرضي
leader and
عرفناه
pious
أكثر
one,
من 30
we
عاما،
know,
كان
knew him
معنا
more than 30 years.
مجاهدا ومعينا
He was
ومساعدا
a
ومسددا
helper and
ومؤيدا،
jihadist and a
وكان
supporter. He
يحب
was,
أن يقال له أنه
would like
خادم
to be
هذه
called
المقاومة وخادم
a
هذه الحزب.
servant of this
نتوجه
resistance.
للتعزية والتبريك إلى إمامنا
We
القائد السيد
condole
الخامنئي دائم ظله، إلى
Al-Khamenei
عائلته
as well,
الشريفة،
to
إلى
his
الإخوة الأعزاء
family,
في قيادة حرس
to
الثورة
the
الإسلامية في
brothers
إيران،
in the
للشعب
Revolutionary
الإيراني
Guards,
الجميل والمضحي والذي يقدم
and
الشهداء،
the
لم
Iranian people
يتوقف عن تقديم
who is
الشهداء منذ انطلاق ثورته في
providing
بداية
these
الستينات
martyrs from the
القرن
beginning
الماضي إلى
of
اليوم.
its revolution in the 60s
نصل
up till
إلى
now.
حادثتنا
Now
الأخيرة
we
حيث
come to
نتوجه
our
للتبريك
latest event.
والتعزية
We
بأخينا
condole
الحبيب
to
والعزيز
our
القائد
brother,
الكبير
the
الشيخ صالح،
dearest
نائب رئيس
Sheikh
المكتب
Saleh,
السياسي لحركة حماس،
deputy head
ورفاقه
of Hamas,
القادة والكوادر في القسام وفي
and
حماس
his friends
الذين استشهدوا
and
بالأمس
in Hama and in
في
Al-Qassam,
عدوان
who were
إسرائيلي
martyred yesterday
واضح
in
على
an
الضاحية
aggression,
الجنوبية
Israeli
لبيروت
aggression
في
to
ليلة
the
استشهاد
suburban
القائد الحاج
or the
قاسم
suburb
الحاج
area.
أبو مهدي. أتوجه للأخ الكبير
I
رئيس
would like
المكتب
to
السياسي
my brother,
لحركة
the
حماس
head of
الأخ إسماعيل
Hamas,
حمدياو العبد،
اسماء
ولكل
هنية
إخواني في قيادة حماس
and all
وقيادة
his
قسام
leaders
وفصائل
and
المقاومة
the leaders of
الفلسطينية
Qassam
والشعب
and all the
الفلسطيني
groups of Palestinians and the people of
العائلة
Palestine
الشريفة للشيخ صالح
and
والعائلات
the
الشريفة
family
لكل
of
الشهداء
Sheikh
الذين كانوا معه
Saleh and all of
واستشهدوا معه.
the families of the martyrs who
التعزية
died with him.
والتبريك والدعاء لهم بالصبر والتوكل
Condolences.
وهم أبدوا ذلك وأظهروا
They
ذلك وأن
for
يتغمد
their
كل
patience
هؤلاء الشهداء برحمته
who
الواسعة إن شاء الله. أنا سأعود
hope
في
that these
سياق
martyrs
الكلمة في المقطع
will
الأخير
have the mercy of
إلى
God
حادثة
in
الاغتيال
the go
والاستشهاد.
to the
طبعا الشيخ صالح
assassination.
هذا
Sheikh
القائد
Saleh, of course,
الجهادي الكبير
this
الذي
leader
أمضى
who has
شبابه
spent
وعمره منذ أن
his
كان فتى
youth
صغيرا
when he
إلى
was
ليلة
very young
الاستشهاد في
to the
الجهاد
night
والمقاومة
of the
والعمل
martyrdom by
والقتال
resistance,
والأسر والهجرة
fighting
والجهاد
and being
وختم
captured
الله سبحانه
and
وتعالى له
migration
بهذه
and
العاقبة
ended
الحسنة
with
بهذه
this
الشهادة العظيمة.
good
أنا
end
أذكر عندما استشهد
as a
الشيخنا
martyr
السيد عباس
when
رحمة الله عليه في
Sid
البرقية
Abbas
التي
when he
أرسلها
died
سماحة الإمام الخامنئي دام
the
ظله
telegram was
قال
Khamenei
إن
has
من
sent he
أعظم
said
ما يمكن أن
is one of the
يتمناه
most
الإنسان أو من أشرف ما يمكن
best
أن يحصل عليه
wishes
الإنسان أن يكون
my
موته
man is
قتلا وعلى يد من؟
to be
على
killed
يد قتلة
on the
الأنبياء.
hands of
وهذا هو
the
حال
killers of prophets
شهدائنا في هذه الأيام.
and this is the case of
أيضا في
all
هذا
our
المقطع
martyrs
الأخلاقي يجب أن
in
نتوجه
this
مجددا
ethical part I would like
ونعزي
to
بكل الشهداء ونبارك بكل
condole to
الشهداء
all the
من غزة
martyrs from
المدنيين
Gaza,
النساء
the
الأطفال الصغار
civilians, the
الكبار
women and children and
والمقاتلين
old
المقاومين البواسل
and the
الشهداء
fighters who are fighting
إلى الضفة
those
الغربية
brave
إلى شهداء
to the West
العراق
Bank, to the
الذين استشهدوا
martyrs of
بفعل
Iraq who
العدوان
died
الأمريكي على
because of the
مجاهدي المقاومة
American
الإسلامية في العراق
aggression on
إلى
the
سوريا
Islamic
الشهداء
resistance,
العسكريين
to
والمدنيين
the
الذين أيضا
martyrs
يستشهدون
military
للفصل
ones and
الإسرائيلي في
civilians
حاضنة
who
المقاومة في سوريا
died
إلى اليمن
in Syria
إلى
to
شهداء
the to
البحر
Yemen
وما
to
أدراك
the
ما
martyrs
عظمة
of the sea
ودرجة شهداء البحر عند
how
الله
great
سبحانه
the
وتعالى
martyrs
إلى
the level
شهدائنا
of
في لبنان شهداء
or great
المقاومة بكل فصائلها
death of
شهداء
them
الجيش
to all
اللبناني
those
والمدنيين
martyrs of
وكل
the
الجرحى
Lebanese
وكل هؤلاء
military
الشهداء
and
الذين
civilians,
مضوا على طريق القدس
all of these
بكل عائلاتهم
martyrs on the
الشريفة
way to
التي
Jerusalem,
تعبر عن ثباتها
to all
وقوتها
their
وصلابتها
families
وإيمانها وتوكلها.
who
وهذا
express
الحال
their
في
own
لبنان
patience.
هذا الحال في
And this is
غزة
the
في
case in
الضفة
Lebanon,
في
this is in
فلسطين
Gaza, in
في
West
سوريا
Bank,
في
in
العراق
Palestine,
في
in
إيران في
Syria, in
اليمن
Iraq, in
نسمع نفس اللغة.
Iran, in Yemen.
في آخر
We
الليل
have the same
واليوم
language.
كنا نستمع إلى والدة
We were
الشهيد القائد الشيخ
at the
صالح
end of today,
إلى
we were talking about
أخواته
the
إلى إخوته
Sheikh
نفس
Saleh's
المنطق
family
في كل
to his
مكان
sisters
التوكل
and brothers
والاحتساب والتسليم والرضا
to
والاستعداد
be
للتضحية والاعتزاز
ready
والافتخار بهؤلاء الشهداء.
to be
هنا في لبنان أيضا هذا
martyred.
حال ولسان
In Lebanon, this
أمهات
is the case.
شهدائنا الآباء
The
الأمهات الزوجات
mothers and the
البنات
fathers
الأبناء
and the
العائلات
husbands,
الشريفة
the sisters and brothers
الجرحى
and sons
الصامدين
of
في
the
القرى
martyrs
الأمامية النازحين
and
من
the
القرى
injured
الأمامية
in the front line
والمقاتلين الشجعان
and the
الذين ما
displaced
زالوا
people
يقاتلون في
and the
الخطوط
fighting
الأمامية. وأقول
people who
لكم
are fighting
خلافا
in
ما
the front
يدعيه العدو
lines
الإسرائيلي
in
الذين ما
contrary to
زالوا
what
يقاتلون
Israeli
عند الحدود
enemy is
عند
saying
الشريط الشائك
they are still
لكل
fighting at
هؤلاء
the barbed
نوجه
front
التحية
barbed
والتقدير
wire front
ونعبر عن
we appreciate and
محبتنا
respect them
وثقتنا
and we express
واعتزازنا
our
بهم
love and
بإيمانهم
our pride
بصلابتهم
in their
بتضحياتهم
belief in their
ونقول لهم كونوا ثقة بأن دماءكم
in their fighting
وتضحياتكم وصبركم
be
لن
assured
يكون
that
لها
all of your
إلا النتائج
fighting
العظيمة
it will have
والمباركة
all these
والمحمودة
wonderful
التي ستعود بالخير
results
على
that will go
فلسطين وعلى
give
لبنان وعلى
good
سوريا
or
والعراق واليمن
be fruitful
وإيران وكل
to
المنطقة
Iraq to Yemen
وكل
and
الأمة
Iran it
من
will give
شارك
them
منها ومن
more
لم
good
يشارك.
and benefit from it
انتقل الى
what,
المقطع
who
الثاني.
participated or and not participated in the fighting. I move to the next part. Second part.
ان شاء الله يوم الجمعه بنحكي اكثر مع عوائل الشهداء
On
ومع
Friday, we
الناشطين
will
ومع
talk about
الصامدين ومع
the
المحاربين.
those who are displaced and the
يوم
families
الجمعه
of
بدي
the
احكي
martyrs on
لبنانيات
Friday.
اكثر.
I will talk more Lebanese
ما نراه
issues.
اليوم
What we see today
في غزه وفي
in
كل
Gaza,
ساحات وميادين المقاومه
in all of the
يحضر
resistance
معنا الحاج
scenes,
قاسم سليماني
we have Qasem
قوه
Soleimani present
واسما وروحا
as a name, as
ونهجا
a spirit,
وعنفوانا
as a system,
وحماسه
and as
وحضورا اكثر
enthusiasm and presence.
في الشهداء اليوم في كرمان
The
يذكروني ايضا
martyrs in
في
Kerman
كلمه
today,
الامام
they
الخامنئي
remind me
فيها
of Khamenei
يبدو
when he said,
ان
it seems
الشهيد
that
قاسم
the
سليماني
martyr
يعني قاسم
Qasem
سليمان
Soleimani
الشهيد يخيف قوى الاستكبار
is
والصهاينه
fearing
اكثر من قاسم
all
سليمان
the
الحي.
Zionist
اليوم قاسم
entity
سليماني
more
الشهيد
than the one,
نراه
the one who dead,
ولذلك
who's dead is
يلاحقونه
being
حتى
feared more
قريب
than the one who is
يكتبون
alive.
زواره. قاسم
Even
سليماني
in
الشهيد
his tomb, they are
الذي
killing people
بشهادته
there.
اصبحت حياته
With his
اقوى واقوى
martyrdom, his
واشد
life has become more strong, much
واكثر
stronger,
حضورا.
more
نراه في
present.
كل ساحاتنا
We see him
وجبهاتنا
in
ووجوه
all our
المعارك
fronts,
ومقاتلينا
in our
وشهدائنا
faces of the leaders and
بصناديقنا
our martyrs,
وصواريخنا
in our
وقذائفنا
rifles, in
وعبواتنا
our rockets, in
في
about
دموع
in our
الاطفال في
homes,
صبر
in
النساء
the
في
tears of the
هذا
children,
الصمود
in the
الاسطوري.
patience of women.
اليوم قاسم سليماني
Today,
حاضر
Qasem
في هذه
Soleimani is
المعركه
present in this
وما نراه
battle
اليوم هو من
with, in
ثمار
force, with force. What we
تضحيات
see,
هذا
the
القائد
fruits
الجهادي
of
الكبير.
this leader,
تضحياته على مدى بالحد الادنى على مدى 20 عاما منذ ان تولى
his
قياده
struggle
قوه
for
القدس
over
بحرس
20
الثوره
years
الاسلاميه في
when he got
طهران
the
والتي تتولى
leadership of a
والتي
Quds
تتحمل مسؤوليه
group
التواصل
which
مع
has
حركات
got
المقاومه وساحات
the
المقاومه
responsibility
من
of
قبل
communicating
الجمهوريه
with all
الاسلاميه
the
الكبيره.
groups.
الحاج قاسم طبعا في
Haj Qasem,
المناسبات السابقه تحدثنا
in
كثيرا
the previous
ولكنني
events we
اريد
talked
ان
about it a lot,
الخص في عنوانين
but
فقط
I'd
هذه
like to
الليله
summarize
لاصل
that in two
منه الى
titles
بقيه
so that
العناوين
I will get to the rest
ومنه
of the
لاصل ايضا
titles
الى ابو مهدي.
and to get to Abu
العنوان
Mahdi.
الاول
The
هو
first
دعم
title,
حركات المقاومه في
to
المنطقه
support the resistant
ودول محور المنطقه،
movements
لكن
in
كان
the area.
التركيز بشكل اساسي على حركات
But it was
المقاومه في
more
المنطقه.
of the resistance
وكان
movements
ايمانه
in all of the region.
ومدرسته وثقافته
His
ونهجه هو
school
التالي:
and his own
دعم حركات
culture and
المقاومة
to
تقويتها
support the
تعزيزها عدة
resistance groups
وعديدا
to
خبرة
support it in
تدريبا
numbers
تصنيعا.
and equipment in terms
ومن
of
علامات
also
الإخلاص
training
الشديدة
and
في
manufacturing.
عمله
One of
للمقاومة
the
أنه
loyalties,
كان يسعى
loyalty
لتصل
to
كل
the
حركات
resistance,
المقاومة إلى
he wants
الاكتفاء
to get
الذاتي.
all
وبتعرفوا لما دولة
resistance
عم
groups
ترعى
to have
حركات
self to be
عادة بعض
self-contained.
الدول من أجل أن تبقى ممسكة بهذه الحركات لا
Some
تسمح لها
countries
أن تصل
wants
إلى
to
مرحلة الاكتفاء
keep
الذاتي
hold of these groups.
لتبقى
They would not give
مسيطرة
it
على
to be
قرارها على
self-contained
خياراتها.
so that it will
الحاج
be
قاسم
controlling
سليماني
its own
مع الكل
decision.
كان يتكلم
Haj
ويبرمج
Qasem,
ويخطط
he
ويعمل
was preparing
لتصل
and
كل
planning
حركة
and working
مقاومة
with all of them
إلى
so
مستوى
that each
الاكتفاء الذاتي
group
لتعتمد بعد الله
reaches
سبحانه وتعالى
its
على
self-contained
قدراتها على
status
إمكانياتها
so that it
على
will rely on its
تصنيعها
own
على
powers, in its own
رجالها على
manufacturing,
خبرائها
in
على
its own
مدربيها
men, its
على
own
مخططيها على
experts,
عقولها.
on its own planners,
وستستغني حتى
its
عن
own
السند
minds
والعون
so
الذي
that it will not
تقدمه
rely
الجمهورية
on
الإسلامية
any
في إيران.
support from the Iranian
وهكذا واصل العمل.
Republic, Islamic
اليوم مثلا
Republic.
لو أخذنا
This
بعض الأمثلة
work
وكلها
is
وبعض
being
الساحات
continued.
في محاذير أن
Of course, some
نتكلم
of
عنها،
them, there are
لكن
some
مثلا
precautions that we cannot talk
في
about.
فلسطين
But in Palestine,
خصوصا
for
بعد
example,
2000 حركة
in
حماس
particular after
وحركة
2000,
الجهاد وبقية
Hamas
فصائل
and
المقاومة،
Jihad
ولكن
and the
بشكل
other
أساسي
resistance
حماس والجهاد
groups, In particular, Hamas and Jihad. And it is not a secret anymore. Hamas and Jihad are announcing this every time and every event. Support, money, and the ability to manufacture, to manufacturing, and trading, and all of the what happened. All of these championships, all these achievements in the battle, it's not the, it is not born yesterday or 1 year, about 2 decades of being born over 2 decades, which has been done by Hamas and Jihad and other Palestinian groups and the force of Jerusalem and the guards. All of them are doing, putting what they can. And the Iraqi resistance, Muslim resistance, after the 2003, when groups from the Iraqi youths and chosen to fight the American occupied forces and started fighting, finds in Hajj Sulaiman and its Jerusalem force, they find them there, the refuge that will be supporting all the money and weaponry and training and exchanging expertise. Abu al-Mahdi al-Muhandis, we're talking about before Hajj. We are talking about 2003 and 2004. He was the the most important personality next to Soleimani to coordinate the work of resistance and to help Hajj Qasim in the resistance in Iraq, which has resulted in a historic victory. In these days, the American forces have been drawn from 2011. It's true it was an agreement with the government, Iraqi government, but what forced it to withdraw is the resistance from 2003 to 2011. This is the resistance that has got very strong, and its people, we know them. And he did not give up supporting them, that resistance. And the US people were threatening. They will hit the headquarters of the Jerusalem force in Tehran, and that they will kill him wherever he was. But he did not hesitate to continue supporting the Iraqi resistance, which has made this kind of victory. And the Iraqi groups, which has formed the nucleus for the popular, for the revolution, popular revolution, when Daesh was or ISIS was the make of the US as a revenge to their defeat in Iraq and the return of Iraqi invasion. The second title of Hajj Qasim's work, it was a work that it was a new and creative and very important one. He was to find this kind of networking, this links, these true relationships and emotional ones between the resistance movements in the region. This is as an evidence of loyalty. This is the axis of the resistance in the latest years, the axle of resistance, whatever you want to call it. This title, this term, it was not there long years back. It has been founded because of the parties of the Axis. But Qasem Soleimani was, he was the central one who has secured the communication, consultancy and coordination and work between these forces. Why do I say this is the loyalty, evidence of loyalty? Each country will manage some of the groups. As for him, he will, his interest is to have the relationship between with him and becomes through him. That's what people who are running the world. But Qasem Soleimani did not do that. He was very keen that there will be some direct relationships between the various resistant groups, between the Palestinians and Lebanese and Syrians and Yemenis and others, through the meetings and communications and collaboration and exchanging expertise and opinions, and have a strategic vision to the whole region, to the struggle in the region. This was his work. That's why the axis of resistance, which does not be understood by many, it's that different from the other axis. He is sitting there and he is managing and he is giving order. Mr. So, you fight, you stop, you become neutral, into pressure more, less more, go into a political channel and so on. The axle of resistance, we will describe it as the second part. This is one of the creative works. The axis of resistance is based on strategy, on paradigms. And here, what Hussein Salami said when he was in the funeral, Ridha Mousavi in Tehran. He has explained that kind of mentality. There is a strategic vision there. In the axis of resistance, we know who are friends, who are enemies, and their targets are clear, what is the interest of the peoples of the region, where their dignity and their freedom and their sovereignty and its independence. Like that U.S. vision, Israeli vision, it decides on its own, it takes its own decision. It is the one who will open its front and closes. It is the one who will make truce or will take this stand or that stand, and in coordination of the or in meeting with the interests of the state itself. So the interest of the Syria will have some interests that are meeting with their own groups, resistance groups. This formula, creative formula, will not, nobody will order anybody. We can consult with each other and advise. We learn from each other's expertise and experiences, but each one will take decision by in the light of their own interests and the interests of their people and their country. And this is what happens to the Jerusalem force. Unfortunately, some of the politicians, but after the writers, some of the commentators, media, they would not understand this scene. They carry on analyzing incorrectly because they are building wrong, based on wrong data. Straight away, they would say, for example, Ansar Allah or people in the Yemen or Abdul Malik's Al-Houthi, brave guy, leader, who decides to fight the Red Sea battle so that it will break the siege on Gaza. They don't know. They think that Iran asked him to say that,
عندما يفتح
and
حزب
that
الله
is not
الجبهة
true.
في 8
When
تشرين
Hezbollah,
إسناداً لغزة
opens the
ما بيقدروا
borders,
يستوعبوا إلا أنه إيران
support Gaza.
اتصلت بحزب
They think
الله
that only
قالت له
Iran has
افتح
actually called
الجبهة
Hezbollah,
إسناداً لغزة.
open the borders
وهكذا عندما بدأ
or the front
المقاومون العراقيون عملياتهم
in
ضد
support of
قواعد
Gaza.
الاحتلال الأمريكي في العراق وسوريا ما بيقدروا يفهموا إلا أن
They
إيران
could not
هي التي
understand
طلبت
that
كذا وكذا.
Iran is
تعرف
the
ليش؟
one who has ordered.
لأنه الدنيا
You know
هيك،
why?
العالم هيك، مش
Because the
حاسب
world
عليهم.
is run like this.
بالعالم
We don't
أي
blame
دولة
them.
عندما
In the world,
تتبنى
any
حركات
country,
مقاومة
when
أو
they
حركات
want to
سياسية أو أحزاب سياسية أو
support
حركات نضال
some political
وطني
group
مثلا وتقدم لها
or
المال
resistant one,
والسلاح
resistance group, and gives them the
بالتدريج
money
بقصد
and
بغير قصد ولكن
weapons
بقصد من أغلب الدول
intentionally or
يحولون
inadvertently.
هؤلاء المقاومين والمناضلين
They make
والمدعومين
all
إلى
these
أتباع
fighting people,
إلى
they become
أدوات
followers.
يتم
They are
ابتزازهم
tools.
بالمال
They can,
بالدعم
they will be
بالسلاح
blackmailed
بوقف
by the
الدعم
support, by
عنهم
the
إن
weaponry,
لم
by
تفعلوا
stopping
كذا
their
إن لم
weaponry if you
تقولوا
don't do
كذا
this,
إن لم
if you don't
تستجيبوا
say
إلى
that,
كذا
if they don't respond to them
ولذلك
in this way.
يتحولون إلى عبيد
And that's why
في تجربة محور المقاومة لا يوجد عبيد
in the
لا
axle
يوجد إلا
of
السادة
resistance,
الشرفاء
there are no slaves
القادة
the way it
الشهداء
is with the others.
الذين
They are
يسطرون
all
النصر
martyrs
لأمتي
who make
هذه هي الصفة
victory for their own nation.
ولذلك هم ما بيقدروا يستوعبوا
They
أنه
do not understand
ما تقوم
or
به
cannot understand
حركات محور
what
المقاومة هي قرارات ذاتية
the movements of the
منطلقة من
axle of
قناعاتها من
resistance it
إرادتها من
came
إيمانها
from its
من
own
إخلاصها من
themselves
صدقها
from their
هي
own
ليست
loyalty
أدوات
and
وهذا
dedication. They're
النموذج
not
اليوم في
tools.
جبهة المقاومة
And
في
this
محور المقاومة
pattern
في
of
منطقتنا
the axle
هو
of
نموذج
resistance
فريد في
is
تاريخ
a pattern
البشرية
that is
وليس
unique
فقط في
in the
القرن في العصر
history of
الحالي
humanity.
هو نموذج
And it's
فريد
not
ليس
only
رئيسي
in the present
ولذلك
time.
هذا النموذج
It's
تعلق عليه الآمال
unprecedented.
الكبيرة
And
لصنع
there will be
الانتصارات
many
واستطاع بالفعل أن يصنع
hopes,
هذه الانتصارات
great
في
expectations.
هذا
And
الطريق
they have made victories
الذي
in this way,
مشاه هذا
which
المحور
or path.
ولذلك في الخطاب الأول بعد 27
That's why
يعني خطاب يوم
after the
الجمعة
7th
في
October,
الشهير
it was on
عندما
a
قلت
Friday,
أنا أن
well-known one,
طوفان
when I said
الأقصى
that
كان
the
قرارا
deluge of
فلسطينيا
Jerusalem,
وعملا
it was
فلسطينيا
a
ومشروعا
Palestinian,
فلسطينيا وهدفا
pure
فلسطينيا
Palestinian in
وأننا
its
لم نكن
aim
على
and
علم
its project,
لم يكن من
and we
أجل
did
أن
not
نأخذ
know.
مسافة من طوفان الأقصى ونحن
Now,
لم
not,
نأخذ
it's
منه
not that we want to keep a distance away
ودليلنا
from
شهداؤنا
Jerusalem,
في كل يوم
Al-Aqsa one,
وقتالنا في كل
but
يوم وإنما أردت منذ تلك
But
اللحظة أن أقول
what I
لا
wanted from that
تدخلوا
moment,
طوفان الأقصى
don't
وأهداف هذه
include
العملية
Aqsa
التاريخية العظيمة
deluge
في
and its
تحليلاتكم
aims in
الخاطئة
your
والتافهة عندما
analysis that are
توقفونها
incorrect
مباشرة
when you
بالمشاريع
link it
الداخلية والصراع
with the
الداخلي إيران
regional
وأمريكا والدور
projects
الإيراني
Iran
و
and
و
US and
هذا الطريق أيها الإخوة
that
والأخوات
this path,
هذا المنهج هذه المدرسة هذا
this system,
الأسلوب
this school, this
الإبداعي والذي
style,
كان
the creative,
طبعا يعود الفضل
which
فيه بشكل أساسي إلى سماحة الإمام
thanks of
القائد
course
سيد الخامنئي
to
دامة
the
الله الشريف
Khamenei
لكن الحاج قاسم
leader
كان أمينا على
and
هذه
Haj Qasim
المدرسة
he
وعلى
was
هذه الفكرة وعلى
very
هذه الثقافة وعلى
keen
هذا
on
العمل
this
وعلى
kind of
هذا
school
التطبيق
and about this
وعلى هذا النموذج
work and about this
ولم
implementation and
يدخل
about
فيه
this
شيئا من هوى
pattern
النفس لأنه
and
لم
it
يكن
not
لديه هوى نفس
put anything
قاسم
from his
سليماني
own
كان ذاهبا
whim.
في الإسلام وفي
He was
وفي فلسطين وفي المعذبين والمظلومين
he
لم
was very
يكن في
keen
جسد
to
قاسم سليماني شيء اسمه
it was
قاسم
not in the
سليماني
body of
هذه هي الحقيقة
Qasim Soleimani there is nothing in
شاهدناها
his body that
ونشهد عليها
is
من قوة
has got any
ولذلك مسار
self
هذه
interest in
الحركات
that's
كان
why
مسار
the
انتصار
path of each of
المقاومة
these
الإسلامية
movements
في
it
لبنان
was
بال2000
victory
بال2006 في
in
حرب
Lebanon we
الصمود
have Muslim
مقاومة
resistance
في
in
غزة
Lebanon
تحرير
in
غزة
July
الصمود
in
في
Gaza
مواجهة الحروب التي
to
شنت
liberate
على غزة
Gaza
المقاومة في العراق
and
كما
the
قلت
wars
هذه هي
against Gaza
الأيام هي أيام
and of course
ذكرى الانتصار
the
التاريخي
resistance in
للمقاومة
Iraq
العراقية
the
anniversary
anniversary of the
التي قلت في المضى
Iraqi
وأقول اليوم
resistance
العظيم في تاريخ العراق
today
الذي لا
the day
يحتفل
of
فيه كثير من
a great
العراقيين
day of the Iraqis, Iraq, that Iraqis don't celebrate. And that was lost because of the differences in Iraq. We have to return, get it back and celebrate it, because there are many have actually lost their lives for their sacred land. And the steadfastness of Syria and Lebanon, these are all the blessings of this method and this style. But the excel of resistance has more. The most challenging for the resistance is this, the Aqsa deluge. From this, I move on to the next Aqsa deluge, which happened on the 7th of October, as you know. It was started in a Qassam group or brigade, supported by the other groups, the other brigades, Palestinian brigades. And the reasons for the deluge, they mentioned, it was mentioned by the leaders of Hamas and the other brigades, and I talked about that in the previous speech. And with regards to the 75th anniversary and the other, the prisoners and the attacks on Al-Aqsa Mosque and the risks of displacement of Gaza people, and to have an internal conflict within Gaza. And the main reason and true reason of it is to displace all or the exodus of all Gaza people. In any case, their reasons, it was clear and known. On the 8th October, Hezbollah has entered the battle on the northern Palestinian occupied Palestine from the southern quarter, frontier of Lebanon. After that, the Iraqi resistance men in Iraq, they started in Iraq and Syria, and targeting the Zionist entity through the drones, and also those in Yemen by attacking the that entity with is the challenge in the Red Sea. It is a very brave and very wise step and very influential, effective. And we know that what's happened, you know, all you are following all the news. What's happening 3 months from 3 months ago is we have many martyrs, people injured, houses being demolished or destroyed, and in the south of Lebanon as well, we have the scene of threats and risks. On that, there is the steadfastness and the bravery and the resistance and the challenging spirit, and to feel disappointed or giving up, surrendering. Of course, the main one is Gaza, and the other parts of axle of resistance. With these two scenes, there are results. We go in and we go and get lost or drown through the details. We want to see the scene in general. We don't want to look at the details. When we look at the greatness of the achievements and results or outcomes that have been achieved up to now, and what's going to be achieved later, then we will realize, we will know we will be more satisfied that of the amount of martyrs that's been in, whether it's in Syria, Yemen, Iraq, and I would like to mention the titles very quickly because each item it needs 1 hour talking. So, but and explanation. But I will just point. It's enough to indicate things. Not everything, because we don't have enough time. What's been said by the Israelis, generals and previous one, the leaders and current leaders and strategic experts in the Arab world and the Islamic world, and some of the Khamenei sermons and many others. But I would like to show you this amount of bloodshed. What are the results which has got a very big influence on the future of Palestine, on Palestine issue, on the Lebanon, on the whole region, in particular on Palestine and Lebanon, and in general on the region. We will go one by one. First, to revive the Palestinian issue after it has become forgotten, and to make it being tabled in every with regards to the two-state solution and so on. Before the illusion, almost the Palestinian issue has been almost forgotten, had it not been for the resistance, Axel resistance. They are betting on the tiredness of the Palestinians so that they give up on the Palestinians. They will give up. When the resistance of Gaza, in Gaza, when they did, and what they have, and what the consequences have been, has actually been disappointing in that. It has not been successful. What they are saying, this is the generation of internet, has actually finished in the West Bank, and it has ended with the upheaval and intifada, but the deluge was giving the final hit. But in front of certain people who will not forget its history, its place, and its, and they are saying that even the Israelis are saying that after 75 years, they are after being exiled and sent away and displacement and these very hard hardships. Now, more support now, the choice of resistance is being supported more and more, despite the massacres. And making all these massacres, they say that the resistance are the ones to blame for these massacres. But of course, the person of doing the massacres is Israel. But this has got very good, a good work for the future of Palestine. After this happened to Palestine, they're going back to the surveys. These massacres will make the Palestinians will give up on the resistance, will blame al-Jihad al-Hamas and fighting men. All of the surveys are actually confirming that the support is going up for the resistance, and in particular to Hamas, which they give it the most responsibility or the highest responsibility. This is the highest support from Palestinians and the resistance groups. This has got very big impact on the future of this struggle. The fall of the image of Israel in the world, which has worked on by US media and the Western media and the media in the Arab world. The 20 formal media in the Arab world, it is to polish the image of Israel, that it is the state of law and democratic state and with respect
to
human rights. In the deluge, what happens afterwards and what's happening in all the frontiers, Israel has fallen, failed legally, humanly, in the eyes of all people of the world, killing women, displacing people from their own neighborhoods, from the, and making people starve, frightening people, frightening the civilians. And it's the most person who is our entity for the genocide in the current century. This will affect the balance of this conflict. In the latest, there is surveys in the U.S. between among the young U.S. young people who do not hear satellite stations, TV stations. It is all the time being influenced by the channels that's been influenced by the Zionists or them. And here are the women and children are being killed. And here the social media, which want them, they want to demolish the resistance, and it has had a back, you know, different effect or a negative effect. More than 50%, not with giving Palestinians their rights, they have to disintegrate Palestine, Israel, and return all the land of Palestine to the Palestinians. Who would believe that this kind of change in the public opinion, this will work? It will have a very big effect or impact on in America, in the U.S.
Fifth,
what's happened in the last 3 months has given a very hard hit to the naturalization, to go around the Palestinian people, and it will be Israel that as a natural state. Six, to respect the international society, community, the American, US, they give us all this. The Europeans and the Westerns and some of the Lebanese that are Americanized or Westernized, that they are, why are you different? And all the world is respecting the will of the international community. Why are you doing that? This deluge, the deluge of Aqsa, has actually made it clearer for the world. Who is actually challenging the will of the world, international world community. 150 states has taken a decision to stop the ceasefire, comprehensive one. Only 10 states, Israel, US, and Britain, and so on. And Israel does not respect that. Who is not respecting the will of the international community? Which resolution has been taken till now? Which one is respected? The 1701, even. Israel has not left one of the official UN official. Israel has not left any law in international law that it did not actually walk all over it or violated it. Of course, the will of we move to the seventh, to the Israeli results. The results, in the light of these, marginalizing the deterrent, Israeli deterrent, and that they are trying to renovate it or restore it. You remember that before the Aqsa deluge, to attack Gaza for to renew or renovate this deterrent, that it will frighten the regional states or neighboring countries, all of them will surrender and will not. It is a force of deterrent. It's a fearing force. From the 2000, it was going down. With Gaza, it's gone down. 2006, it went down. And they said they're going to actually return this kind of deterrent force. After the opening of the Lebanese frontier and the Yemeni frontier, the situation of Israel is actually deteriorating. Hamas and its other brigades, when they have did in the deluge of Aqsa, they will not be frightened. They knew about the results. They knew that the results, but that matter needed that kind of bravery. The resistance in Lebanon on the 8th October, it opened its frontier. It was not being deterrent or deterred, and it is more prepared and more brave. Yemen, when it started, it's taken this step. It was not frightened. It did not take for it into consideration Israel's power. This deterrent, Israeli deterrent, who is relying on the U.S. Fleets, it's not deterring the Iraqi movement or in the Lebanon. That's why it's leaving without any results. So deteriorating or marginalizing or destroying the Israeli deterrent. There's another one, that Israel knows everything and they know everything, which is not correct. The deluge has actually proven that it's not. After War of July, they looked about they have amended some of their strategies, and that they I would like to remind, they said from now on, we go with Israel with having very fast and very clear victory with Israel. Ehud Barak and the others in the Israel chief of staff, they all adopted that strategy. Let's talk about only Gaza. 3 months in Gaza. It's not, there is no fast and very clear victory. There is no in the Israel, in the Zionist entity, that there is any picture of victory up to today. Yesterday, they were trying to show that through the assassination of Sheikh Saleh. But in the Gaza battlefield, where is the fast and decisive victory? Number 10, the failure of the Air Force in Gaza. It's very important with regards to the defense strategies at the 11th one point. With regard to the results of Al-Aqsa deluge and all the other accesses, no confidence in the Zionist entity, in the army, in the political entities. This will affect the foundation of Israel. There are some people, I don't want to use some expressions that are not correct, when they hear that all the leaders in the Hamas and that the deluge of Al-Aqsa to the removal of Israel and on the way to be removed, they will laugh in the deep in content. If it loses its hope, will not stay. It's people, it's the a connection with the land, it's not true, it is false, it is hypocritical, it's not true at all. All of you, the Zionism project, there were four choices: Argentina, Uganda, one of the European country, and Palestine. The English people, English who brought them to Palestine. If there is a fight in civilian war, it will stay in Lebanon, stay with Lebanon. In Syria, stays within Syria and people, its people. Iraq is exposed to siege and it will stay in Iraq. Israel is not the same. It is an artificial entity. It is hatched up from all over the world, has got another entity, nationality. The connection with this land is based on security, and it's not the good land. And then when they lose security, that's it. Why are we talking about these points? The scene that these Zionists who are collecting their bags and leaving from various airports and seaports, and this is the coming scene. This Aqsa deluge has actually completed the foundation of this scene. You want evidence? This is the war minister Galen. I will read what he said. He said, without achieving the targets of the war, to get rid of Hamas, to get back the hostages without negotiation, these are the announced ones or known, and to control admin, political control over Gaza. It was not that his own citizens are not prepared to live, not on the sides of Gaza. It's not the surround of Gaza and the displaced and those who have escaped from the north. People are not prepared to live in this place. Why? Because we don't know how to protect them. What is he saying? We haven't achieved the aims. We have lost the main core that has based the state of Israel. You will not achieve the targets of war, hopefully. Here, the concept of the secure refuge for the Israelis in the world. You're not in the secured or safe, your security is in Israel. Al-Aqsa deluge and what's happening on all the frontiers, borders, what's happening in Gaza, in the West Bank, in Iraq, in the region, has actually hit the foundation of this foundation, and it will make this concept of safe refuge for all the Jews in the world. And now there are many are migrating, and they are most of the elite and those who are the rich wealthy. Breaking the image of the capable Israel, presenting its own self to another Arab country, saying, we're going to protect you, we're going to send you some air force, we'll give you the Iron Dome, and we are the security, we are the intelligence. This image has fallen and has become in a place where they needed to be protected, had it not been for the American or US beats. It wanted this from the first few days. the amount of direct losses, which has been unprecedented. The human people, these are the disabled, those who are announced as dead are not what in reality is. They are in thousands in the killings and injuries. The number of vehicles and tanks that's been targeted, the psychological situation or condition of the soldiers. This is one of the papers is saying, Yedhud Ahrnout, there are 300,000 has been joined the mental treatment. If you stay here, no, there is threat, there is concern, there is very psychological condition. You want to, the ones who's got the US passport or British passport or others, you go back to your own country. And the land of Palestine, from the river to the sea, is to the Palestinians, for those who are steadfast, who are patient. The psychological mental conditions, the opposite migration, hundred thousands migrants who are migrating, 60,000, 17,000. He says 1,000. Benjamin has made a mistake. It's 100. They talked about 230,000 displaced from the north. The economy, 3 months, there is no tourism, there is no agriculture, there is no manufacturing. Israel with no economy, tens of millions of dollars, which cannot be dealt with by the US. Red Sea, of course, this has, the Yemeni work has actually affected the economy and failed to achieve any of the targets. The US is telling the Israeli ones, withdraw from the cities. He's worried about the Palestinians. He's worried about the Israelis. In the resistance, they want the Israelis to stay where they are in the city, so they will hit them in the morning, in the evening, to destroy their banks, the tanks, their snipers, and so by sniping and so on. Israel cannot actually control the Gaza Strip. One of the significant results. Wait until the war stops. Even within the same party, they put all these daggers behind their backs. And when the war stops and the demands and all these courts start to, and investigations, which Israel are we going to get? I don't know, 15 or 16. A scandal of the US. U.S. who has tried to, after the new conservatives, after the massacres in Afghanistan, in Iraq, and brought, and that his black and his father, Obama's father is Hussein, and he is Muslim originally, and they're trying to make their image a bit better, and they managed that game, through that game. And then the sedition of the of ISIS and the Arab Spring, and they always, they've created ISIS and so on. The Aqsa deluge, that one of the its targets has actually destroyed this image of the US, which with its worst realities. Whoever is killing is the US strategy and the US rocket and bombing and their strategy. And what stops the war in Gaza is the one who is preventing the war from Gaza is the US, who is giving the veto in the Security Council. The rudeness of the US, that their spokesman, Israelis would not intend to kill, and there are 20,000 civilians, and they made all these are collateral damage.
أظهرت أمريكا هي الخارجة على المجتمع الدولي وعلى
US is the only one who is going violating the international law on the human rights and human values. The last that I will give to you without the final part, we have to learn the lesson from Gaza, that it has, that all the international UN and the international system and the international law is unable to, are not able to protect any protection of any nation, any individual. Learn it, Lebanese, those Lebanese people. 22,000 martyrs and around 60,000 casualties, and give us, give your weapons. The international community is going to protect us. It's not that we have one opinion and another opinion. This is blindness. This is blind sight. ولكن تعمل القلوب التي في الصدور. Now it is the hearts which are blind.
هذه التجربة ماذا تقول؟
This experience, what does it say to us?
هذه التجربة تقول.
I'm going to now the last part. This experience is saying, if you are weak or vulnerable, will not be recognized by the world, and the world will not defend you, and the world will not cry, even not, it would not even cry on you. What the one that would protect you, the one who protects you, is your force, your power, your bravery, your weaponry, your rockets, and your presence in the battlefield. If you are strong, you will force others to respect you. Despite all the besiege on Gaza, if Gaza fell in the first few days, nobody would cry over it. This amount of force, the moral and the material, which is very limited, that the mass resistance, the people, the men and women and children, this is a form of force, has forced. Everybody's trying to find resolutions because there is a form of force in Gaza, despite of being suppressed. Here I will go into Lebanon. There are so many results, and there will be more results. I would say what happened on the 7th of October till now, what will happen later, has made Israel make weakened Israel. Has actually shaken its foundations and its buildings. And yes, as the Palestinians are saying, and put it on the way to be removed, which we will witness, hopefully witness, will not be protected by any side, and no one will be able to defend it and protect it. As for the Arab, here I go into Lebanon. When we opened this frontier on the 8th of October, area, so that I'll be frank and clear with you. You know, to be closer to God, to support those who are oppressed in Gaza. We will explain them even more on Friday. This brave participation, which was based on what I've mentioned earlier, our decision is meeting with the strategic vision to support Gaza and to look after the interests of Lebanon. In the end, we are living in a country with its own challenges. We left all this and we went into this formula of fighting. It's very, very effective, very big. Hundreds of operations have been done, many martyrs, many casualties. Gains, very big, I will talk about on Friday. Leave them until Friday. Now, but there is more, which is more important from the blessings that we have entered on the 8th of October that we want to draw your attention to, which has actually showed that being what the negotiations or discussions of the enemy, in particular the mini government there, on the 7th of October, say 8th of October, the Israeli has went mad. They're worried about the existence. Gennett has called it the second existence or staying, and getting out of these differences, and they recalled reservists. There is more than 500,000 reservists. So this is within the cabinet. This has happened later. It appeared later. This is because of the resistance in Lebanon has actually been fast to fight. They said, Israel, this is our historic opportunity. We get rid of all these resistance groups in Palestine. We want to remove them all. In the West Bank, we're going to actually get rid of them. And we will get rid of in Lebanon. We will finish the threat from Hezbollah in Lebanon. And now all the world is crazy with us, and they think that we are being, it's our chance. But this fight, this war in Lebanon has been stopped by Iran. The element of surprise, if the Lebanese frontier was very calm on the 8th, 9th, and 10th, 11th, 12th, they would have woken up and Israel would have actually destroyed everything in this country, because the international world is with the community with them, and they were thinking seriously about that. But the resistance is the one who's opened the frontier. We have actually mobilized all of the training camps, and this has made them lose the element of surprise, the power of the resistance in Lebanon, the greatness of the resistance in Lebanon. You know that if you go in Lebanon with war with Lebanon, and he's fighting with the Gaza, the U.S. don't go into a brick wall. Now what you need to, the war with Lebanon, it's going to be very expensive, and it's going to threaten your existence. That's why they considered what they've started in Gaza would scare the Lebanese. The most important message on the 8th of October and the 9th, when it's opened from the sea to Sheikh Mount, that it is very brave and strong and will not fear anybody, and it's not being deterred, and it has no, it should not have any calculations that will stop it from doing what it's do, what it did. This is the strong message. There was some discussion and some discrepancies or differences. The Israeli, I went to Netanyahu and tried to convince him not to open a war with Lebanon, because that will affect it will affect Gush Dan, this rectangular shape in, with Tel Aviv. What made Israel to stop or not to launch a war, that there is a force, that there is resistance, and that there are people who are men of God. This is the status quo. What we are doing in the, on the border, if it was where, if there were no power of this, they're talking about 700 operations. One operation would have been enough to launch a war against Lebanon by Israel. We want to respect all this world community or international community. Or is it that the Lebanon is very strong? All these threats and warnings, they were attacking in the southern suburb. There are two titles. This is killing of Saleh and his friends, Sheikh Saleh. And it was done in the southern suburb. That's the first after 2006. Yesterday there was some messages. The Israelis said we did not intend to, we were not targeting Hezbollah, and we are trying to settle that with Hamas. This will not be convincing except to the children or to those who are cowards. Accept that. All of these threats and warnings, I don't want to warn or threaten. I want to rely on the past. I want to say two sentences at the end of my talk. The first sentence, that till now we are fighting in a frontier, and we know the calculations. That's why we pay the martyrs of our people. But if the enemy has thought of launching a war on Lebanon, it will be fighting with no borders, no rules, no limitations, no guidelines, and they know what I'm talking about. Our records, our fighting, our threats, all of this, all what we mentioned in the past, we can talk about it. I want to remind you that we are not scared of the war. We are not hesitant. We would have stopped. U.S. have threatened us. The French have told us long messages. The British, the French, the Germans. Have we stopped? Did we retreat? Did we hesitate? Whoever thinks of the war with us will regret it. It's going to be very, very costly. We are looking after the international, the Lebanese interests. If there were war on Lebanon, then the international national interests, that we will go to the war with no limitations or no restrictions. With regards to the event yesterday, the resistance have actually promised, if it were in different circumstances and there were no war or balances of the conflict, it will not change anything. The crime yesterday was very grave. We will not be quiet about, and this does not require words. This crime will not be without any response or punitive action and the battlefield and the days and the nights between us and them, you. Goodbye.